I just gotta say, I can't believe it. Akiflow finally did it. I'm getting emotional.
They made an ocean sink that's pretty decent, so we're not gonna jump into that in this video. I guess I might be able to act a little bit, who would have thought? I actually almost got myself to tears doing it. So on the bottom left of your screen, if you go to settings and in integrations. So if we go into the integrations and press connect, we're gonna get an OAuth authentication request. So I'm gonna go pick my backend page that picks up everything. I'm gonna copy the link from my workspace. Paste it in there, grab these and press allow access. So then it should say connected. And then if we go back here, press add, you'll see that it has different workspaces that you can select. So I have, for example, my projects that are in here. So if we get to my project database, you'll see that there's a bunch of different properties here, but there's status, due date, and those are some things that I can basically pull into the workspace. If you don't see your workspace here, refresh the list, and that'll be something that takes a little bit of time. To what tests to import? Only pages assigned to me. That's a really good one. I honestly really enjoy this. So for example, you can see that it actually cares about the assigned property. So I actually want to keep that as such. So only assigned a test to me. Select assignee property, and that would be to me the team one, as I just showed you. Custom import filters, add more filter options. So what you can do is you can also say status is not archived, and or you can do an or option, status is not complete. Select completion property and value. Okay, so that would be status, and then completed, and then undone would be status not started, probably, I think, contextually that makes sense here. Select the schedule date, so that would be the due date. Select the deadline date, so that could also be the due date. Now, say, for example, if I had a property for project timeline, it doesn't seem like it's going to give me the option to do a beginning and end, but for me, due date sort of means project timeline, and if, say, for example, I had a timeline for a project here, we use this as an example, started this like last week, say I want it to end here, I want to see how this reacts to it, so we're going to test that out. So let's do save changes. Okay, so now this is a configured workspace here, and you could add more, and you'll see that there's a bunch of different stuff within here, but we're going to just do what I had with the projects here first. So if we go back to Akiflow, exit out. Another thing is if you uncheck these and change them to none, it'll actually move it to your inbox in Akiflow. And then really quickly, I'm just going to add something like my tests and events really quickly. And I just want to import task type is ad hoc task to show some examples. And the checkbox is my done and undone property. And then we can figure out whether we want to have a deadline date. So I have a due date and a time here. So I'm going to do time for this as an example. And then it's going to start syncing for me. You see is happening in the top right. So you'll see a bunch of stuff just got brought in. So this is a bunch of different projects that I had. And then in the inbox, you can see there are a bunch of different projects as well. And then if I click on this guy right here, it'll actually open the link to the project itself in Notion. This is my native Notion app. It didn't even open up in a web browser, so that's pretty nice. Now, just like with anything else in Akiflow, you can quickly drag this onto your timeline here. And on the calendar, you could put a work session for yourself. And then you'll see if I press check on mark as done, it'll ask you whether you want to mark it as done in Notion. So you have the option to do a few things. You can remember the choice, or at the beginning of this process, you can set how you want this to happen. And I'll go back really quickly and show you after I uncheck that what that was. So if we go to settings again, Notion, you go to projects, you can configure. Do you want it to be one of these different things? So I'm going to have it say mark as done in Notion. And if you remember, the done filter is status completed. So if we go to status of this again, so we go to the podcast rebrand project, press checkbox on this guy, what'll happen is it'll say completed in Notion. And then if I untick it, it'll go to not started. Now you'll see that I made that mistake. And I think what would make more sense is if contextually, if I'm unchecking something, I'm probably going to end up doing something along the lines of unchecking it back into in progress. So that would make more sense contextually. So let's try that again. If we go back in here, check this guy off, podcast rebrand will be complete. But if I uncheck it, it'll go right back to being in progress in Notion. You can do the same thing in here and add different priorities like high, medium or low. You can add labels just like anything else. The only nice thing about this is that it literally just syncs to Notion. There is nothing crazy excessively good about a lot of these different things. I do want to point that out. There's a lot of times when people think that these integrations are like next level in the sense that they'll like sort of game change their productivity. It just changes, you know, do you want to have a ecosystem of task management mixed with your project and calendar management on one place? It, like if Notion got a better daily planner aspect to it. And you can do a lot of those kind of things with systems that I teach and that I work with in my consulting. You know, it'd be a lot simpler. Literally, once they have the Google Calendar sync, I think a lot of this will be a little gratuitous because you can make views that are similar to today, upcoming, someday. That means for me, like, okay, what's the point of apps like these eventually once Notion improves their functionality? But I do see the point of it existing for now, especially with integrating with other applications outside of just Notion, like Todoist and other ones like your email. I'm not going to complain anytime someone does a Notion integration though. And I'm not going to complain if you check out this video right here.